In this lesson, we will see how to iterate through a list to execute logic on each element. We are going to implement a delete order action that will delete all the items associated with the order and then the order itself. So let's go ahead here into the logic tab and let's create yet another user action. This will be the remove order user action. And again, we will need to have information in this action of which order we want to remove. So we'll have an input parameter that in this case will be an order identifier. The first thing we want to do in this action is actually to fetch the order items from the database. So let's go ahead here into the data tab and drag and drop the order item to create the aggregate. Let's filter these order items with the order ID. So add a filter here. The order ID attribute of the order item must match the input parameter of the action. There you have it. So for this order, we will have, let me just show here the hidden attributes. For this order, which is number one, we will have these products with these quantities and this price. Okay, that's done. Let's go back here to the action. Now that we have fetched the order items, we want to iterate through this list the result of the aggregate. We want to iterate through each one of these order items and remove them from the order. And to do this, we're going to use this tool here, which is the for each. This allows you to iterate over each element in a list. And in this case, let me drop it here in the flow. The list that we are going to use is the result, the list property of the aggregate. Okay, so now we need to, for each element, we need to remove the order item. So we're going to reuse the action we created in the previous lesson. And this means that we need to connect the for each with this action. And you'll notice that this connector here says cycle. So this means that while we have elements in our list, this action is going to be executed. And after this action is executed, we'll go back into the for each, and this creates this loop here that iterates over each order item that we get from the aggregate. Okay, this action here needs an input parameter, and the input parameter is actually the order item that we will get from the aggregate. This is the list that we are iterating, okay? So this is the order item that we want. This current property here will point to the element that's currently being iterated in that list. So this is the element that we want to use here for this action. And that's done for deleting the order items. After we delete the order items, we can now safely, let's go here, we can now safely delete the order. And we need to specify the identifier of the order that we will get from the input parameter of the action. And that's it. Okay, so now we want to use this action in our screens, and we will use the action here in the order detail. And for that, we will add a new button here to our form, and we will call it delete. And let's double click to create the screen action for this button. And here in this screen action, we are going to use the remove order user action, and we'll need to pass the order ID. So this is the input parameter of this screen. And after we delete the order, we redirect the user back to the order screen. So here. Now, let me just rename here this screen action, because we already had a delete to remove the order item from the order, and this will be the delete order. And let me just do one other thing, which is indicate that this button is only visible when the order actually exists. So when the order ID is different from null identifier. Okay, and one other thing that I want to do here is there's another property here for the button, which is the confirmation message. When this property is set, the user is prompt to confirm this action when the button is pressed. So we want to make sure that the user knows that he's deleting an order, and we will have here a confirmation message for that. Are you sure you want to delete this order? And this text will be used to prompt the user for confirmation of this action. And we're done. And all we have to do now is test this. Let me just add here a breakpoint. Let me add a breakpoint here in the screen action so that we can test this using the debugger. So let's start the debugger. You can do it here. And let's publish our application. Okay, so let's go into the order screen and let's open this last order from Tom. And we have order item here. And now we're going to delete this order. There you have the confirmation message. Are you sure you want to delete this order? Yes, I'm sure. And now we're stopped here in the screen action. Let's step over and let's step into this remove order. We're passing the order ID, which is number 5, as we've seen in the screen. So let's step into so that we have the debugger going through our user action. Now we will fetch the order items from the database. Let's see the list of order items. There we have. We have one order item to remove, which is the MacBook, as you've seen in the screen. Now, we will cycle through this list and we are going to remove the order item. We can step into here and the order item that we receive here, it's this one. We're going to fetch the product. We're going to update the quantity in stock. So we're going to have one product in stock there. Update the product, delete the order item, and we're done. And we will continue the cycle, but since our list only has one element, this means that we will no longer enter here this cycle. We will continue to delete the order. So next, delete the order, and we're done for the user action. And finally, we're going to redirect the user back to the order screen. So let's just continue here. And there you have it. The order was deleted. And if you go to the products, the stock for the MacBook Air is updated and we have now one item in stock. And that's it.